Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jay Lee. I joined EMEA 3 months ago from American Express because I saw that EMEA was well positioned to take advantage of innovation and focus around the customer and the new relationships and interactions that companies can create for them. I'd like to focus my remarks on some of the key dynamics that we are seeing affect the loyalty market in the US and the opportunities that they create for EMEA. And I'd like to cover some of the exciting work that we are doing with some of the best brands in the world. But first, let's put the US loyalty market in context. The US loyalty market is the largest in the world, and we believe it is roughly currently about a $10 billion addressable opportunity. Companies have recognized that loyalty programs need to be a core component of their business strategy. You can see this from some of the key US statistics. US loyalty program membership exceeded 2 billion in 2010. That happened through a doubling of total memberships in the last 10 years. And the average US household is a member of 18 loyalty programs. With loyalty programs more popular than ever before, differentiation and innovation is critical. We're seeing tremendous innovation and disruption enter the space, and in many cases, allow companies to create effective loyalty programs where they have not historically been able. So let's talk about some of the key trends that we're seeing affect the loyalty market, change the market in exciting and challenging ways. The first key dynamic is certainly one of my favorites, and that is the innovation in the payment and the e-commerce space. Digital wallets and mobile payments are creating ever more convenient ways for consumers to purchase, for companies to target customers and offers to consumers. It's no longer just about enabling convenient and secure payments, but actually about enabling a more robust buying experience where companies can affect the purchase behavior of customers. From our own research, we know this is an area worthy of focus. Millennials, the next generation of customers, are quickly seeing their phone as a key gateway to their reward programs. Recently, 26% want to use their phones as a reward card. 77% of those want to download coupons and certificates. 60% would redeem points through an app, and 59% want to receive exclusive offers through their mobile device. And innovation here is really just starting. You know, the most recent example of this I think we heard last week was from Apple's iPhone 5 and their Passbook app, which integrates the digital wallet directly into the operating system. This simple app allows consumers to keep concert tickets, boarding passes, gift cards, and most importantly for us, loyalty cards, all in one easily accessible place. You know, imagine the potential this creates for an explosive growth in engagement in loyalty programs. Next, as I think you've heard many times today, there's a rush to capture as much information on customers as possible and to sift through that information to drive business performance. As you've heard, most companies are ill-prepared from the IBM survey to deal with these massive data sources from emerging digital and social channels. And not only do companies need to manage this information, they need to appropriately use this information so as not to disaffect customers. And we see from our research that customers are most willing to allow corporate use of their information when they feel it is truly meant to benefit them. We believe loyalty programs will become the natural hubs of consumer information given our long-standing good stewardship of that information. Consumers are most willing for companies to use their previous shopping habits and history to benefit them with discounts and better product recommendations. Loyalty programs are the vehicles to obtain vast transaction and behavioral data due to their inherent permission-based structure. They allow us to capture personal and preference information that other marketing tactics are unable to access. And in many cases, loyalty programs are the only way that companies can capture key personal information about their customers. Finally, perhaps the most compelling consumer attitude for our business is that loyalty programs create preference and a trusted communication channel for brands to connect to customers. Again, from our research, we see that loyalty program communications rank very high in terms of importance and relevance, second only to your finances and, ironically, your cable provider. With all the new channels available, loyalty programs are one of the best vehicles for marketers to send and to have consumers actually read the right message in the right time. As these market dynamics continue to take hold, businesses need to quickly adapt their marketing strategies. They need to quickly incorporate new payment technologies and related communication channels for end customers as adoption grows. They need to extract customer insights from newly available disparate data sources. And they need to establish trusted relationships with customers to ensure that their communications have been their intended consequences. These dynamics are pushing loyalty into the heart of marketing and customer engagement strategies. And we're positioning Aimia to help companies deal with this great wave of market innovation. We're making investments into three core areas of our business in the US: loyalty strategy, loyalty analytics, and loyalty operations. For loyalty strategy in the US, there's actually a great demand right now from companies to understand how their loyalty strategy fits into their business and how they can reimagine their existing programs. With a tight US economy lately, we've been performing strategy work around program redesign and modeling of economic resulting impacts. For loyalty analytics, we're investing in capabilities to help our clients tie disparate data sources together, make better, faster, and more relevant decisions. We're also integrating analytics deeper into vertical-specific strategies, and I'll give us an example of that. And in loyalty operations, we're taking advantage of our existing proprietary assets that we have, like our code unpack process and patent, while investing in a more scalable loyalty platform for the future that can be stood up faster, reduce startup costs, and make it easier to get to analytical insights. So let's walk through a couple of examples of how we're working with clients. P&G has been a long-standing client of our US business where we run the Pampers Gift to Grow program. In the program, consumers find codes printed inside of packages for products such as diapers and wipes. They receive points for entering codes online, and these points can be redeemed for relevant awards. Our Code Unpack technology is a very effective way for CPG companies to connect directly with customers regardless of distribution channel. But this program is far more than just a way for to give awards to customers for buying Pampers products. In the program, we use insights from the data captured to affect the purchase decisions at each stage of the customer lifecycle, from purchasing wipes and diapers for newborns through the first 3 years of a child's life. What's new is that Pampers now intervenes with personalized offers at key points in the purchase lifecycle, such as when we determine that a consumer has defected to a competitor's product, or when complementary products are not being bought, such as members that buy diapers but don't buy wipes. Knowing each customer and presenting offers to each person using a loyalty currency gives P&G more effective control of marketing spend that isn't possible with traditional promotional efforts such as couponing. In another example of our loyalty analytics, we do business with a leading supplier of pet healthcare products marketed through veterinarians. As you can imagine, there's a ton of data in this supply chain, including vet data, pet owner data, and industry trends. By leveraging vet-level pet owner behavioral attitudes and incorporating third-party household demographic data, we're now able to better discriminate between pet owners and better target our communications. This year, we've had the best year ever with the program, and through our analytics, we were able to increase the ROI on the program to its highest level in its 13 years. And that's great for them in this kind of economy. And the last case I'd like to share with you is our partnership with Kellogg's. Just this past June, we launched the Kellogg's Family Rewards Loyalty Program. They are using our Code Unpack technology as the backbone to support a consumer loyalty program designed to create engagement and excitement about the Kellogg's brand and hundreds of products. Consumers enter codes found inside specially marked Kellogg's Family Reward packages to collect points. These points are redeemed for sweepstakes, high-value coupons, merchandise targeted at Kellogg's target audience. The KFR program allows consumers of multiple Kellogg's products to pool their points across disparate purchases. Does that sound familiar? By entering these codes from multiple brands, Kellogg's has deeper insights into purchasing behaviors and can identify their most valuable customers. This wealth of data allows Kellogg's to target and cross-sell and upsell opportunities in micro-segments based on members' transactional behaviors. In addition, the program gives the Kellogg's brand marketers a common platform and currency to award customers for each of their brand-specific promotions. This not only provides streamlined process across brands, instead of each one of the different brands creating their own campaigns, but it also provides a much better customer experience. Members are more willing to participate in these promotions because Kellogg's makes it easier for them to do that on a single platform. Using a single loyalty currency as a universal payoff for all brand promotions is quite literally a game changer in the consumer packaged goods space as they go direct. So I've shared with you some of the very interesting live case studies that we have in the U.S. We're really excited about the work we're doing with P&G and Kellogg's, two of the top 10 global advertisers. What we're really excited, of course, is that they chose Amio to be their loyalty partner. So hopefully you see we're making some traction in the U.S. And positioning the U.S. customer business for growth by focusing on higher value loyalty strategy, better leveraging our intellectual property and patents, and delivering high-value analytics to our clients. One of the things we know most about loyalty is that there are many avenues to connect to the customers, as Liz had mentioned in the beginning. And we have a unique business model in the U.S. To help clients with all of their channels. So clients need to manage all of the touch points, including direct, retail, employee, and distributor channels.